Hey everybody, welcome back. Today we're going to be reacting to the next track off of Harry Nilsson's album Nilsson Schmilsson called Early in the Morning. Thank you very much for joining me. I kind of just want to jump right into it. This is a shorter track, so this is probably going to end up being a shorter video. If you're new to the channel, my name is Daniel. Here we react to music and I try to figure out what the music and the lyrics mean to me personally. If that sounds interesting to you, consider subscribing if you want. And I also have original music if you ever want to check that out, and I'd really, really appreciate it if you did. You can find it in the link in the description. Yeah, just a warning though, if you do check any of that out, a lot of it's like experimental or whatnot, so, you know, but I'm really proud of it, and it is rock and folk music oriented, so you might like it. Let's get into this. Loving Harry Nilsson Sussmar. So smart, so far.
Early in the morning, I can't do right. Had a little fight with my baby last night, and it's early in the morning. Don't you know it's early in the morning? Early in the morning, I ain't got nothing, no nothing but the blues. I went to your girlfriend's house, but she was out. I knocked on your daddy's door, but he began to shout, and he said it's early in the morning. Don't you know it's early in the morning?
2 a.m. to be precise.
Early in the morning, I ain't got nothing, no nothing but the blues. I went to Doobie Chase to get something to eat. The waitress looked at me, she said, Harry, you sure look beat. I'm saying it's early in the morning. Don't you know it's early in the morning? Early in the morning. 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 Early in the morning, I ain't got nothing but the 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 blues. Early in the morning, I can't do right. Had a little fight with my baby last night, and it's early in the morning. Don't you know it's early in the morning?
Okay, then. That was a very, very simple song. I liked it, though. One thing about Harry Nilsson that I've noticed is that he writes very, very relatable songs. About, like, these very, very relatable kind of situations, you know, like, just that feeling of, oh, it's early in the morning, you know, people are like, what's wrong, you know, I just look like this. yeah, I like it. Let's see. Probably hadn't thought about this song for 40 plus years, but I woke up at about 4 this morning, and by 5, this song was running through my head. We had and loved this amazing album when we were young. Now that I've lived a good hunk of life, most of it as a musician of sorts, I much more deeply appreciate the brilliance of Harry Nilsson, and this song in particular. Maybe he didn't do it in one take, but maybe he did. Sometimes less is more. What an utterly minimalistic song. Great vocal talent. Yep. Best song coming on the FM radio while driving around at dawn after doing a bunch of acid that night. Been a big fan of Harry's ever since. Was Summertime in 1974. Was kind of like heaven. I really like that. I love how the sound of his fingers hitting the keys is even louder than the chords themselves. It's Daniel Johnston core, is what we can call that. one of the best musicians I'd never heard of until I saw this CD cover in a relative's collection. Maybe the bathrobe got my attention. It was Love at First Sound. Every other song had me asking, hey, where do I know this from? And or he wrote that? Nilsson should be a lot more famous than he is. I said that, I think, in the first video that I did, that I started this, so it would have been Gotta Get Up. And a bunch of people were like, no, he's plenty famous. You just don't notice it. But, like, I feel like he's underrated. Maybe I'm wrong. But, like, you know, with, let me think. What are some examples? I don't think it's just that I haven't heard of him. You know, like, I had heard of Pink Floyd and Led Zeppelin and Bob Dylan and, you know, lots of bands and famous artists from this era before starting the Reaction Channel, or, you know, I see them talked about by my, you know, peers and stuff. So it's, I feel like this guy should have more recognition than he does. I don't know, though. I mean, not recognition, more, a bigger audience. I need to see more people talking about him. Anyway, I will be the one to incite that. Here we go, guys. We're gonna flood the internet with Harry Nilsson propaganda. We are going to show the world the brilliance of this incredible singer-songwriter. All right, early in the morning, I can't do right. Had a little fight with my baby last night, and it's early in the morning. Don't you know it's early in the morning? I've got nothing to do. Ain't got nothing but the blues. I went to your girlfriend's house, but she was out. Knocked on your daddy's door. He began to shout, and he said, it's early in the morning. Don't you know it's early in the morning? I went to Doobie Chase to get something to eat. Waitress looked at me and said, Harry, you sure look beaten. I said, it's early in the morning. Possibly a reference to Dookie Chase, a historical Creole restaurant in New Orleans. In Louis Jordan's original lyrics, the restaurant was Jenny Lou's. Oh, is this a cover? This is not his original song? Don't you know it's early in the morning? Ain't got nothing but the blues. Early in the morning, ain't got nothing but the blues. It's Dookie Chase, a famous soul food restaurant in New Orleans, where Louis Jordan, who wrote the song, came from. All right. Cool. Oh, I liked the track, you know? Probably not my favorite off the album, but I like it, and it definitely serves the record as a whole. That's one of the cool things about liking full albums, you know, and listening to full albums is not every track needs to be like a single, you know? There can be interludes, there can be more minimal things, there can be 10-minute long songs, there can be all types of fun stuff, you know? And I've known that for a while, but I wish more of... That's one thing I wish more of my peers liked and cared about, is like the construction of an album and like thematic elements to an album. You know, now every once in a while, like a pop artist will release an album that has like one or two major themes, not a concept album by any means, but like we'll have something like along those lines, and every single comment will be people saying, this is the most brilliant thing in the world, no one's ever thought of this before, this is so, you know. And I just think to myself, I wish more people knew about conceptual records and just albums that are meant to be listened to as albums, you know, to the point where it wasn't as much of a surprise when there were those. Anyway, I'm rambling now. Thank you very much for joining me. I will talk to you again soon. Stay tuned for more videos.